Hey Lewis Turner here for Guitar Interactive Magazine, back with another guitar review. And in this one, I'm checking out the Music Man Cutlass guitar. And here it is. Fantastic looking instrument. And as we're going to see, it's a fantastic sounding instrument as well. So we'll go through all the various features on it and the different sounds we can get out of it and see what this Cutlass guitar has to offer. Okay, so starting down the headstock. We've got the traditional Music Man headstock that is very famous by now, and the model name there. It's a very neat and tidy headstock, very intuitive to use, and it's very well weighted actually, despite its kind of bulky look. All right, flipping it over. I've mentioned before, one of my favorite things about Music Man guitars of late are these locking tuners that they use. Really, really stable, really easy to use. Just pull the string through, tighten them up, cut the string off, and away you go. Really stable, and like I say, really simple to use, great for quick string changes. No problems there at all. Highly recommend them. Okay, so on this particular guitar, we've got a maple neck, and we've got the five bolt-on neck joint with ample scoop out lower horn, top horn, making a real thin neck joint. So upper fret access, when you flip it back over, we'll see, is a breeze. On the back of the guitar, you can see the belly contour there. We can also see the finish probably a bit clearer on the back here. So they call this natural aged yellow finish to give it the vintage kind of look. Here we've got the housing for the trem system that we'll go through. And also here is a housing because, well, we'll see later on the type of pickups that this particular guitar has. Okay, flipping it back around. Carrying on with the maple theme, we've got a maple neck. And on this particular model, you're paying a bit more because we get stainless steel frets, and definitely an investment worth having. They're pretty small ones, they're not particularly chunky, but stainless steel frets are nice and silky to use, you know, to string bends, etc. And the great thing about them is they don't really wear out, or they take a lot longer, a lot more effort to wear out than your normal frets do. So you pay out at the beginning for the addition of stainless steel frets, you're probably gonna make back without having to have a refret so often, if ever. So stainless steel frets, big fan. They're great, they last for forever. As I said before, upper fret access in this 22 fret guitar is an absolute doddle. You can get out there, no problem at all. Nothing to stop you getting around the fretboard. Really nice action and really nice feeling neck as well. It's quite a thin neck, but it feels great, and the natural finish on the back makes it nice and easy to move around. Okay, onto the body. So this particular model uses alder wood, and this is a very light guitar, which is excellent, light and well balanced. And alder is a classic kind of wood combination body for these style of guitars. Gives that that sound that we're so used to from single coil instruments. We've got the Music Man's own bridge here, which is also very stable. I'll come into a little bit more detail about that in a second. So the cool thing on this, we've got three single coils, and these are Spectrum Music Man silent circuit coils, which is why we have the battery pack in the back there. Those of you that are used to single coils will be familiar with all the hum issues that they bring, depending on what stage you're playing on and how well it's earthed, etc. So normally the hum issues you get are on the bridge pickup. Out of phase ones tend to be okay. It's normally bridge and neck that you get this awful hum from. And, you know, we're in the studio now. We've got lighting and PA systems, etc. And there's, as you can hopefully hear, there's no hum coming from there. It's on, but we're not getting any hum from here. If I switch to a dirty channel on the amp, we're still not getting any hum, so that's cool. What a lot of people will argue is that silent, because of the electrics involved in having a silent circuit, you lose some of the natural tone of single coils. Well, that's going to be down to your own ears, but I have to say that playing with, well, I'm going to go through the pickup sounds in a minute, and you can make your own mind up, but I haven't noticed any reduction in tonal quality. So we've got a five-way selector switch, volume, and just the one tone control, rather than sometimes a lot of these style guitars have two tone controls. So one tone. So let's check out the pickups and see what they're like. So you heard it at the start there on the out of phase, like fourth and second position on a clean sound. Actually, let's go back to clean just so we're getting a real sense of the pickups themselves. So we start at the bridge. Here's my bridge sound. Nice and jangly. As you might expect, onto our face second position, we're aiming for that quacky kind of sound. Which we are getting. That's a real favourite, you know, those kind of... those kind of sounds. Middle pickup, let's check that out. Sounds great. Onto what I call the fourth position, so in between the middle and bridge to give us a nice warm sound. That's one of my favourite, that and number two, one of my favourite for single coils. We're still getting the quack, but we're getting a bit more warmth to it. And then onto our neck pickup. Plenty of bottom end, but still the clarity for the top. And so you can do the old trick where you put it on the neck and then roll back the tone to try and give it like a hollow bodied sound. Kind of works. So there we have it. There the pickup sounds, and to my ears, you know, they sound great. They sound authentic. The silent circuit hasn't taken anything away from the inherent tones of single coils, and like I say, really authentic, really powerful for single coils, and nice lot of sustain, and all the tones. There's no surprises there. Everything I was hoping to hear, and that mix with especially the out phase for me playing single coils a long time. You can really start to hear on the lighter guitars that kind of quackiness coming through more. So tonally, I think these pickups are great, matched with the wood. It's making it sound really cool. So the bridge I said I was going to mention. So we got the Music Man bridge mixed with these tuners, provides one of the most stable tuning guitars I've come across, actually. Any of the Music Man ones that have this setup are wicked. This one's not set up to float, it's set kind of very stiff, but you could change that with your spring selection and claw, obviously. And a pushing in trem arm, so that's great. A bit of dirty sound. Sounds wicked. Everything you'd hope for, you know, a classic kind of three single coil layout, and on a just a, you know, they're aiming for the vintage feel, the vintage look, and it does that in spades. But with the modern edge of having the reduced hum, actually no hum in here at the minute, I don't know what it'd be like at really high volumes, on a really nice playable guitar. So you've got all the great vintage sounds, but on a guitar that's usable in this day and age. So that's great. So there you have it, the Music Man Cutlass. Great looking, great sounding, great playing instrument. I definitely recommend you go and check one out and try one out for yourself. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.